Everyone had it. Perfect. Thank you very much, Teresa. And thank you for everyone for attending today. I'm really grateful for the opportunity, recently becoming a referral partner with the BACD and having these opportunities to present in front of you all. Again, doing it in Durham, keeping it local, and I'm happy to be able to provide that local marketing feedback. My name is Eric Perez-Salas. I'm the founder of StandOut Social Marketing. I thought there was a question. In February of 2017, with that passion for helping local businesses. I graduated from Durham College and Ontario Tech University with my legal studies degree, but found myself pivoting into the marketing and entrepreneurship role, mostly because of a family business. And that is where StandOut Social Marketing was born. I have a franchise business owner in my family that was getting started, was front-loaded with a lot of marketing material, ideas, things telling them what to do, and needed help in that navigating. So I was very lucky to be a part of that ground up building of a local business, doing it all in Durham. And then I was able to take those results, that service, and you know, that being able to provide that opportunity across North America. So what I've done is I've been able to take the advocacy that I built in my legal studies and university, but then I took it to the small business world, where I'm now helping advocate for business owners and getting them the best results online. So for today, we have some pretty clear learning objectives. Today's session is on the Google business listing, the ability to post there, best practices, and how we can take a full advantage of this free resource brought to us by Google. Today, we're going to go over recent changes, as there's been quite a few of them since the 1st of November in regards to the Google business profile, reasons why you want to post on Google, how you can post, the content policies, best practices for posting. We're going to go through some posting ideas and look at some great examples to hopefully influence that creative side. I'm going to share some helpful resources for the Google business listing specifically. And then at the end, my hope is to have that time for some Q&A and provide specific, you know, situational feedback for our attendees. So I'm going to start with some of the recent changes for Google. So anybody who actively logs in, uses the Google Business app in the past, or love to utilize that dashboard, you may have noticed some things changed, and they changed rather quickly. Some of the things we knew were coming, but others kind of fell in our lap, and we've been working with our clients to, you know, keep them ahead of the curve. So what happened? So on November 1st, there was a bit of a washing of a lot of the tools that were available to us. So we knew that the Google app was going to go away, and you'd no longer be able to access that dashboard through your mobile app, and that we would have to use search and map features. What we didn't know was that the dashboard feature that was available to us online and on desktop would no longer be accessible to the average user. So if you try to log into your profile manager, there used to be that very beautiful dashboard. That is no longer accessible. They've removed certain video capabilities and the ability to upload video and use in posting. They've removed specific content sections for your photo uploads about, you know, parking and your team members and some of these really broken down ways to update content. They removed certain post types like the COVID-19 updates and what's new posts. And also with that, the ability to resize images. Now, to show how quick this has been changing, I was actually notified before the session today that that ability has now been restored. And when you are doing your updates, you can resize imagery to make sure it fits. So that shows how quick it has been changing. Your business profile now has to be managed either on the Google search page or on the Google's Maps page. And we'll talk a bit about how we can access that today. There were also some changes to Google support availability, how we can contact them, the expectations for response, and so forth. So I know you can look at this list and it seems like, wow, they took away a lot and they're supposed to be helping the small business and putting a lot of effort into this tool. Our understanding is that these changes are going to happen quick and that a lot of this will be restored and these abilities back in our hands. But for the time being, what we're doing is working with our clients to navigate and still make full use of these tools available to us from Google. So what you will find today is the presentation was updated to a bit more technical, maybe than the creative, but because of these recent changes, we really wanted to make sure our members and our business owners are aware of what's happening so they can be ahead of the changes. So with all of that said, and the reason we're here is, you know, why do we want to post on Google? There are so many platforms where we can share our message, social medias, blog sites, your website. I mean, another place to post, really. One more thing to add in the calendar. But the shorter answer is yes. And for two main reasons. One, Teresa brought up a great point earlier. Google, especially in Canada, is where people are searching for what they need. 97% local company online more than anywhere else is where they're finding us. Over 90% of adults use search engines. You know, the internet's not just for kids. When you go down further, Google specifically has 90% of that search share. And almost 50% of all searches that happen on Google have in local intent. They're looking to buy, get a service, have something completed. There is intent and it's free. Google is not charging us for this ability to grow our brand, so to not take full advantage of it really doesn't make sense for the local business owner. The second portion is, as a business owner, you want to build visibility, credibility, and profitability with your business. So you need to show up in search and maps. You want to directly communicate with the customers and give them a timely experience with information. You want to be sharing your sales, specials, products, services, events, features, up-to-date news, all of this that, again, builds that visibility, engaging your customers with photography and reviews and response and messaging and all the features. We want to make Google happy. So when they provide us with a tool with all this functionality, the business owners that are taking advantage of it are building good favor and good trust with Google as well. And who are your customers going to pick? If they're in a situation with two service providers with two similar looking profiles with reviews and photography and logos and branding, the differentiator could be a strong posting presence below your reviews, where you're sharing offerings, sharing updates, getting signups for events. That really could be the separation between you and your competition. So these are two strong pillars of why we want to be posting on Google. Now comes the fun part and the navigation of how do we create these posts now? So in the past, we would have gone to this page and you could have clicked through to a full dashboard that offered you posting and a guided approach. That no longer exists. So we're not going to touch on that in this presentation, but I will share the various ways you can now go on and create updates. So the first way, and on desktop, is you can still access this profile manager screen if you have a Google listing. And in the third column, there is an updates button. I've kind of got it highlighted here with the square. You can click on that feature and it will give you one posting option for updates. So that is one way right now that you can post on Google is through the Google Profile Manager. However, you are only given one of the available options that we will talk about. The second way is on your desktop using the Google search page. In the top, if you were to either Google the term My Business or your business name specifically, you will be presented with this, the new dashboard that was given to us from Google. I'm not going to touch on all of these points, but as you can see, everything from your edit profile, getting reviews, seeing your performance metrics, editing products and services, all those features are still available to us, but we're accessing them in a new way. And on the screen, you can see again with the arrow, the add update feature. So the ability to go to the first page of Google, Google your business, and do updates right from the homepage. This is what Google is promoting right now. Another option using Google search is on your mobile device. If you were to do a similar search, either My Business or your business name on Google, on the left, you'll see what you'll be presented with that first initial block of you manage this profile and here are the options available to you. And near the bottom, there is an update section that if you click on that, it will then open up the currently three available posting options, which are updates, offers, and events. So we've touched on desktop search, mobile search. You can also go through Google Maps. So if you open Google Maps, same search, look for your business, your profile, or if you're logged in with an account that manages it, it should prompt you right away. But find your business on Maps, scroll down slightly. On the left, you'll see the updates tab. And when you click that, it will then bring you to, again, where you can add offers, events, updates, and finalize your posts. So when you do that, whether it's on the desktop or mobile feature, you are then presented with the three options that were given at this time. As I mentioned in the past, they had a what's new option, a COVID-19 news and updates option, but they have scaled it back. And our belief is they're just going to refine and give us better options in the future. But at this time, these are the three main options for us when posting. So just quickly looking at each three, when we're adding an update, we're giving a 1500 character description limit, the ability to add photo. We're hoping to see video make a comeback. We are really hoping. There's some great video content, so fingers crossed. But then the ability as well to add a call to action and a link associated with, or if you do call now, the phone number associated with the listing. So the add update is the most basic way to produce content. The second is your add offer. Again, if you're in product services and you have a specific offering, we're getting into the Christmas season. I know a lot of people are doing sales and promotions. Use the specific tool for that and fill out the title, the start dates, check all the boxes or as many as you can. But this is the way now, if you do have specific offers and promotions, you can do so through the Google profile. Again, only using photography, hopefully just at this time. The third feature is the event feature. Again, with the BACD in Durham, really promoting even our presenters and how we can utilize this to promote the event. But having a clear, specific title, your start dates, all the information that is available, providing a call to action or link to the event, where they can sign up, where they can get more information. But being specific, if you have an event, don't just add an update, you know, really use that event posting feature. And then just quickly, I wanted to show the different calls to action that are available to us right now, ranging from the ability, the ask for someone to book down to call now.
Eric, is now a good time to pause just to get some questions in?
Sure. If we've got some in the chat.
We've got a lot, so I thought we'd better get to them as quick as we can. So one, do you recommend geotagging photos for posts?
Yes, whenever possible. Again, if it's a checkbox you can fill out and give yourself that ability to, hey, I'm here, it does impact search and local search and discovery.
Okay. Good, next. My business profile was suspended for suspicious activity. I submitted the reinstatement form, any advice?
21 days has been the average wait time. We're gonna talk about policies and guidelines a bit today. And I mentioned the support has been a bit lackluster. They're still claiming COVID-19 is impacting their ability to respond promptly. I just helped a client with two profiles. The average wait time, one was 14 and one was, I think, the 18 or 20 day mark. And it really just is getting it in and more so now being proactive because they're very slow to help us, but we can position our profiles to hopefully just not be faced with that.
Okay. I don't know if you're going to talk about reviews at all, but a couple of questions. Can we talk about fake reviews or hidden reviews, number one? And number two, if a customer wants to review your business, where's the specific link? Did you show that on the other page where it said add an event and then ask a review?
We're not going to touch on reviews today because that could be an entire one. I will share very quickly is here.
Right there.
This is what you're ask for a review. And you can still get that coding and create a QR code, et cetera. Okay. But yes, there's been a lot of changes with reviews as well. And that's been a headache since COVID, but
okay.
I will offer that.
One more, can't get my website added to my Google profile.
That is an interesting one. Might have to do with security protocols, but that is definitely an interesting, we would have to kind of get specifics on that.
Could that be because if your business is home-based?
No, that would be a separate, if they're directly not allowing the URL, that is something we'd have to kind of look into specifically.
Okay.
Not a common occurrence, but.
Okay, another question. How often do you recommend updating your Google business profile if you're looking at events and posts and everything here?
You're really serious about it, no less than once a week.
Okay.
It should be a part of your daily activity almost.
So. Thank you. That's it. You can keep going.
Excellent. All right, so we've briefly gone through again. So you've gone to the position where you can add an update. You've selected the update that you want to make. Now, what does that look like on Google? So this is also why these posts are super impactful, is where they sit in your profile. They nestle right below your reviews at the bottom. So if people are searching for your business and the thing they want to see is reviews, if you have a strong posting presence, they're also going to see that when they're searching at the reviews. So it's very powerful to know that. Again, when we look up a business, we're doing it probably because we want to see the testimonials, and we can ensure that if they're looking at our testimonials, they're also going to see our up-to-date content. Another thing I want to share, because again, instead of us giving us a nice dashboard, now we have 50 different places to add updates, is the ability that if you are viewing your Google profile and you are just looking at your posts and logged into the right Gmail kind of manager account, you can also add an update directly from kind of viewing your listing as a searcher in that way as well. And when someone clicks on it specifically, they will get kind of a popped out version of your post where they can click through, see the full, you know, if there's multiple photos, scroll through. On the left is an example on desktop, and on the right is an example on a mobile device. So I am going to go over the content policy because it was brought up right now, and it's becoming increasingly, you know, important that we're ahead of the curve with Google because of their response times. And honestly, lately, they've just been quick to pull the trigger. They will just disable, suspend, not give you the, hey, change this or face it. They're going to suspend, disable, and then give you a pretty ambiguous email that says you did one of the things on this list, so figure it out. That's been the theme as of late. So I'm going to take a sip of water before getting into this, and we'll go through it.
While you're sipping, do you want to ask a few, answer a few more questions?
Sure.
How much do I need to spend on Google Ads for them to get traction?
Oh, I'm going to leave that one just because it goes into a different ballpark. We'll keep it to the posts, Google posts.
Does a client require Gmail to leave a Google review?
Yes, a Google account. A Google account.
Google account.
Yes.
There you go. What size should images be on your post? Somebody answered that already. Thank you. That's it. Continue. Great.
Thank you.
Thanks, Teresa. Joe, for helping.
All right. So we'll pop into some of the policy here. I've kind of handpicked a few that are pretty maybe common, but more than ever, we're really trying to reinforce. So off topic or irrelevant, you know, sometimes even that website issue, I don't think this is the concern, but if they don't think your website aligns with what you're trying to say on your business listing and your post is nothing related to you, they may disable, take away, remove the posting because it's just irrelevant to the business. Avoid spam. So this happens a lot, especially if maybe the content isn't professionally done, peer edited, misspellings, grammar, overcapitalization, spam style postings, things of that nature, uploading low quality content, stolen content, things with watermarks. I mean, these things maybe in the past we got away with and were able to do, but Google's kind of swinging the axe quick right now, and they are just rejecting posts, removing posts. So you got to kind of be ahead of the curve. Inappropriate content. Of course, we don't harass or bully or disparage anybody with sexually suggestive or explicit. I know sometimes the old adage was sex sells, or you know, using some of that imagery, but Google really is trying to create kind of a pretty family-friendly place where anyone can search and find relative, you know, information. So I know that does come up sometimes if you think of like boudoir photography or services that really border on that. They have to be mindful with the type of content they're posting and what they're saying and such. respecting privacy. So this is a big one. Maybe you run a restaurant, you want to take photos of your customers. We want to make sure we're getting people's permission, that they're aware that that's a possibility maybe in the restaurant or where they are. Never posting anything government issue, SIN numbers, personal identities of people, anything of that nature. Being the good neighbor. So again, maybe you're a home-based business and you're taking some photography, but you know your neighbor's car with the license plates or street signs, we want to be very mindful of things like that. Illegal content, alcohol, tobacco, gambling, things that you know you probably have to be heavy regulated, and not just anyone can start posting bottles of their homemade whiskey for sale or anything of that nature, or even just having it in your content as a part of the piece. Being mindful when using almost shock content or things that might be seen as that. And then the misrepresentation and misleading claims, just again, identity, who you are, who are you representing, acting on behalf of a business, maybe you work out of an office, but it's not actually your space. You're not promoting that you own or operate or do anything that's really outside of your business that may be deemed misleading. So, these are some of the strikes we've seen lately. A big one we've seen a lot as far as posting content and it being removed is the use of stock photography. So it goes under the kind of guidelines for photos and video, but Google's really pushing for organic content lately. And they are going after, whether you've purchased or not, they're not asking for proof of ownership or the ability to share. They're going after content where they're seeing the same image used a lot across industries. And they're really trying to focus in on that organic, you've done it, you've created content. So that is something to keep in mind. And I do know there is an article related to that available. Any quick questions about the guidelines? Anything pop up in the chat, Teresa, specifically to the guidelines, policies?
No.
All right.
We're good.
So I'll quickly move into some best practices when we are posting on Google. So number one, read the content policy. If you are someone who wants to take this on for yourself and in your business, taking the time to read over that policy, the guidelines, you never know what might stick out to you in your business, something you've shared in the past, a type of post you've done or content you've used. Again, for the sake of being proactive, because Google's heavy-handed right now, they're disabling, they're suspending, they're rejecting, whatever reason, it is important to be ahead of the curve and know what you need to know before you need to know it, is what a great HR person I know has said to me. So go read the content policy if you want to be posting and managing your Google profile. Two, use photos or, again, videos with the double thing because they've taken it away momentarily. But if you're posting, you can technically do it without this, but we highly encourage you find something of content to share and kind of really double down on the post. It will make you, again, stand out from that competition. And when people are reading your reviews, they might not even see the post or recognize it if there's not that piece of content to go with it visually. Headlines and post text with the need to know details. Yes, there's 1,500 characters. Nobody's probably going to read your 1,500 character Google post. They're going to go to the reviews. They want to see the first 150, 200 characters, and those need to speak to them. They need to solve their problem. They need to know what they're getting into when they click. They need to be specific. Keep it what they need to know. Keep it brief. That goes with it. Again, you really want to take advantage of the first 150 to 200 characters that are going to show if they don't click through to the post. One thing I will say about the Google post, the engagement isn't super high right now. It is a lot more impression based and there is some engagement, not like social media. People aren't going there to comment and click and engage quite at that level yet. But again, keeping it brief really helps your opportunity to get that engagement. Having a call to action, again, it's something you don't need to have in your post, but why wouldn't you have some form of call to action for a client or potential customer to take related to what the post is about? So don't leave without a CTA. And six, post frequently. Once a week minimum, why not take some of your best social media content, repurpose it? If you're product sales, if you've got things moving that are of relevance to your customer or client, they will find value daily. get on there and post. We've got a sale today. We've got our wing combo on Friday and freeze pizzas on Sundays, and really utilize this tool that's not going to penalize you the same way social media might for overposting. Google's the perfect place for if you have an ask daily to ask those people who are searching for you. One thing I do want to mention that has come up is the use of hashtags. So I'm fine with using hashtags in your Google posts, especially like our BACD event. If they're a part of that theme and that opportunity, the only thing to know is it doesn't work the same as social media, where it's not generating signals and traffic based off the hashtag. Quite like on Instagram, you can search by a specific tag and know how many people are posting. It's more or less if it's a part of the brand and a part of the message.
By thank you very much, Teresa.
But it doesn't have the same impact like on social media. So now what I'd like to get into. So really, we've kind of gone over the technical side. Where do we look to actually post now and use updates? You know, what is most user-friendly to you as the business owner? What are you most likely, what path are you likely to take to post those updates? What updates can you do? Where are they showing on Google? Why do you want them to show on Google? All of that I think we've covered really well and in depth. Now is, you know, time to get into more of the creative. And, you know, I'd like this to even be a bit more of a mastermind opportunity where we'll have people comment and engage their experience and some feedback. But what I want to get into now is the posting ideas. What can we post to Google? What type of content should we be sharing? Look at some posts that we've managed, and just to give that local example of really how to take advantage of this tool. So what I have here, 10 ideas for your next post. So the goal of this section, what I'd like to do is, as I go through these ideas for posting, I'm going to ask the members here, one, if they have anything related to that. So number one, we have upcoming events. In the chat, I'd like you to put, do you have an upcoming event and maybe what it is? This is an opportunity to maybe network a bit. But then beside it, I want you to put a dash and then either yes or no that you've posted that to your Google business profile. So I reach out to the chat and the business owner here. One, is anyone here hosting or a part of an upcoming event and maybe what it is? And then two, in the same line, have you posted it yet on your Google listing? So I've got some people. Ooh, make a will a month, November. Yes, we have some people have been posting on their Google profile. And then same thing with a special offer. So we'll keep kind of the ball rolling with who here right now is offering a special offer or a promotion, anything like that going into the holiday season through their business. And then have you posted it on your Google business profile yet? I want to keep the chat open because I would like to actually share some of these as they come in. Yes, we've got some events. Some have been posted, some have not been posted. We have some special offers coming up. Again, some have not been. What about a new product? Does anybody have a new product that they've released or come out with, or new service? And have you been posting it to your Google listing? And let's see what some of those are. I see a New Year's Eve event has not yet been posted to the profile. I see someone with a new product that has been posted to their profile. What about a holiday? We're coming into the holiday season and there's a lot of opportunity there for holidays. So yes, we have our, you know, generic, our kind of consistent holidays, but who here is celebrating something maybe they've come up with or a very specific holiday that they're trying to promote? And again, do you plan on sharing that message on your Google listing? Or is that Google, you know, post not even a part of your holiday celebration? And maybe should be. It can also be a great way to show your customers that, you know, we know who you are and that you celebrate and your customs, what you're a part of, and we're going to celebrate that on our postings. updates about their business. Who here in the last 3 to 5 years made a big change? Phone number, new address, new location, new website, emails, any type of information change that wasn't shared in a Google post. That type of information that if someone's looking for you, especially specifically, if they're looking up your business, would be good for them to know. Hey, we're here now. COVID, big changes. We've upsized, we've downsized, we've moved. Sharing that information. Great review. Who in this room in the last, let's say, week or two received a review either on Google or Facebook or any other platform, but hasn't shared that? I know on social media, we love the Testimonial Tuesday, but who has taken that Testimonial Tuesday? And yes, I know the posts are right below the reviews. They're going to see them anyway, but shared that, created content around it to celebrate. The product or service we've talked about, you know, maybe not something new, but what is your core offering? What is your ideal? What is that one client you want to work with more than ever? And are you letting Google know and people searching for you know that that's what you're looking for, that we provide this service, we can help you, we can relieve that, you know, pain? Let them know through Google. I love 8, celebrate a business milestone. Who's in their fifth year? Who's in year 10? Who hit $1 million? Who just hired somebody? Again, new location. You're celebrating internally. You've probably shared it on social media. Who has celebrated a business milestone lately, but again, hasn't taken the opportunity to post it over to Google, and who has? And 9 and 10, just show some personality, you know, show your true colors. I love repurposing from social because I find people put so much effort into their social media content that I don't want to break them down too much and think, oh, now I gotta create for Google. No, take that real promising social content and, you know, give it even more firepower over on Google. And say thank you to your customers. Again, if you're hitting a milestone, it's probably because people have been buying, using, staying true and with you. Take the opportunity that when people find you, they can see that you're someone who recognizes and says thank you to your community. That can be a very impactful posting. See, I love that, Amanda. Yeah, taking advantage to say thank you and making sure and knowing that Google's where they find us. So that's where we're going to recognize them. I'm seeing some great ones. I see someone made a review video. That's something, again, we need. Google's going to give us our video capability back. I think they have the means to on their end, but I love that. I love seeing the Black Friday sales that are being posted and utilizing. It really is a tool. And I would say there's a pretty good mix in this room today of people that are utilizing and really involved with the Google listing, and definitely some opportunity for people that are saying, hey, I've got this happening, but maybe there was a couple no's there. So, you know, my call to action is if you leave this event and you're comfortable, you know, post that event, post that milestone, really get it out there. Last slide for this, because I do want to give some visuals, you know, to really kind of follow up on the good old text block. But here are some examples of clients we've worked with and different ways we've utilized recently, and I've tried to keep it recent with the changes, ways we can post. So travel agents that want to share information about, you know, where you can go and the benefits of using them. We have our e-commerce and our product sales, you know, really pushing into this holiday season, specific sales and products and, you know, driving the call to action to order online or chat with them directly. In the bottom left, again, recognition, celebrating a milestone, being an award winner and utilizing that in your content calendar. An example from my own business, we made sure to post about the upcoming BACD event and use the event feature so it shows timing and that ability for clients to click through and learn more. And also, again, a local wellness clinic, same thing, recognizing whether it's their blog posts or new practitioners or anything going on in their clinic, we want to let Google know about that as well. So the chat, I think, was a great place. I don't know if there'll be many questions, but really take a look at that chat and get some good ideas from other businesses in your community, what they're doing and what they may or may not be posting about yet as well. There are 3 resources that I do want to give to the people in attendance today. They're all free from Google. The first is the link to specifically the content policy for your Google business profile. And I'll make sure these links do get sent out and are accessible to everybody who was attending today. Free online training. Google has a lot of courses online and skill shops and ways you can learn. This one is specific to working with the Google business profile, being a local small, quote unquote, small business owner, and how you can take full advantage of it if you are someone that's driven to, you know, DIY. And another thing that Google's recently rolled out is a free marketing kit. So there's some stint to it, and we still have some clients that aren't quite showing up in the list to access yet, but they will provide you a branded kit that will pull reviews and create posts from it, your review link in a QR code format, any stickers or any promotional material related. And the reason behind this is they focus on storefront businesses with a location where people walk in, and they want to give them material that not only helps them promote their business, but shows that they're partnered with Google, that, hey, leave us a Google review, see our Google, you know, content and things of that nature. But there is a free marketing kit available to most business owners that meet kind of the criteria. All right. This is the time where I will now leave it kind of open floor if anyone would like to put questions into the chat, and Teresa can forward them.
But I think people can also unmute themselves and talk. So I just wanted to check back to see if there was, you remember the one question you said, let's stick to this. We could answer that question.
If there's anything, post related, we'll try to prioritize that first, but now I will leave it open. Anything just Google business profile related as well.
Hi, Eric. Thanks for the presentation. I'll just chime in, I guess. It's Amanda here. So I asked that question in terms of how much, you know, ads should you invest in on a monthly basis. But I guess the posts themselves, the more quality content, if I'm understanding correctly, will increase my, what is it, search engine optimization?
That's the goal.
Yeah.
Kind of in short, you're building trust with Google as well as your customers.
So do you have tips on the type of like words or phrases that you should be using, or is it just really, you know, your business? So, you know, I'm in legal, I would say pick family law and whatnot. Yep. Like, is there any tips for how we can know what Google is picking up as those keywords?
Yeah. So it's not quite as, like I mentioned with the hashtags in social being a way that you can really kind of distinguish. Google hasn't outright said that they're like keyword picking. Our recommendation, though, for the purpose of Google being an intent-based thing, you want to prioritize content that is generally speaking to the searcher, using the keywords and phrases that you believe they're going to be using to create that kind of correlation. Like, oh, I searched up best family lawyer here. And then you talk about in your postings that we're a family law office that's operated for so long in the community and we're involved. I know you mentioned too, like adding the personality, your friendly, you know, neighbor lawyer. Yes, like there's not that direct correlation yet from Google, but we are emphasizing that it's content that's more based on search, knowing that people are going to find you because they were looking for you here, and you want to speak to that, maybe more so than social. That can be a bit more like, hey, you might not have been thinking about this, but we're just kind of posting at will. It is a bit of a different.
So no tool to help you understand their methodology. But what about purchasing words to improve your, how high you're rated on that search screen, right? Like, how do I get to be number one?
So if you want number one, it's reviews. If you want number one, it's reviews. That is the, your listing has to be fully optimized. And if everyone's posting in your industry, the last great divide is the person who's got 10, 30, 50, and then the industry's got 100 plus reviews. Google is going to take those reviews, and it might often trump the posting and a lot of the other stuff. So at the end of the day, review acquisition is always number one.
Okay. So if you're in a very highly competitive segment and there's no chance of you you know, as a new business owner, having more reviews than somebody more, the myriad of other established in the community, how do you differentiate yourself? Is it by paid ads?
So the quick way is paid ads. You put money, you throw coal in the fire, and the train goes. Yes, you're a new business, day one, new website. I can get you on the first page in probably 48 hours. That is the power of advertising, but it comes with a price tag. Now, what you then hope is you're building clientele through paid advertising that are going to leave you reviews. The other strategy, and a BACD is a big part of it, and their networking events, is find something in your community, become a part of it, build a network of trust where people might even just give character review and like their referral and like build your review that way. Because you're right, if you're starting at zero and you've got a couple of clients, but they maybe don't even feel confident leaving the review, they don't want to be the first one. Tapping into a network of colleagues, trusted professionals, referral partners that will sing your praises and leave you a review that's legitimate, not spam, not inappropriate. That can be a great way to get your first 10. Then you outreach to clients, get to, you know, 15, 20. Now you're doing paid ads. You've got a great client load. Okay, we're at 50 reviews. Now we're starting to compete with the top in the area. But it can be a grind. When you talk about organically in a competitive industry based really off reviews and feedback to climb that ladder, and paid ads is the kind of the escalator to get there.
And sorry, one last question. This has been very helpful. Thank you. Is there any way to leverage reviews on other platforms? So does Google permit, for example, me to somehow take my LinkedIn reviews versus asking individuals to go back and now use Google?
Sorry, I'm going to have to re-ask that question. I made the mistake of looking at the chat and I apologize.
You want me to re-ask?
Yeah, yes, please.
Basically,
I'm so
can
sorry.
You take a review from, is there something in Google that allows you to leverage reviews from different platforms?
Yes. So the business profile itself, as long as they're accredited, I know like Constant Contact and there's like Reviews 360, Facebook, Homestars, I believe. There are some that if your profile is set up appropriately and Google can correlate and like tie you to social media profiles and these other review sources, they will actually show them on your listing as well in that review area. You'll see like 10 on Google and then 5 on Facebook and 5 here, and it will actually fill out the profile. But you're also allowed to then just take that content, make a post, put it into a graphic through Canva, and then just share it and say, hey, you know, you're on Google, but check out what they're saying about us on Facebook. And that could even drive people to say, hey, that's a review from Facebook. We're going to go look at your social media. But you can definitely, one, Google does it automatically. Two, you can create content and cross-post it over.
A couple more questions for you. I'm sure you saw them in the chat box. Is there an ideal time for posting?
Now. No, in all seriousness, it's when you have the ability to. And can do it. And if you're someone with a lot of information on your business, and maybe you know, hey, you know what, Mondays and Tuesdays at noon, I look at my listing, my numbers are up. I look at my Google Analytics, my numbers up. I look at my sales and they're up. I'm going to prioritize my posts Monday at about 9:45, and it's going to be an offer. It's going to be a promotion. So there's the balance of right now is always the best time, especially if you haven't been posting at all. Don't worry about the time of day too much. On the other hand, if you are someone who's very in tune with your business, use the data that's available to you. Take some time, look at the numbers, know when people are searching for you, and then take advantage of that time.
And when you say look at the numbers, you're meaning people look at your Google Analytics, right?
Yeah. So either the Google profile.
Okay. I mean,
it's a long way for me to scroll back, but there is the view performance button.
Okay. Thank you.
And you can actually see things over a quarterly period. The times of day and when people are most active on your listing. You may have even gone to a restaurant and you'll see in the bottom, like, oh, this is the busiest time of day for them. Basically using that information.
Okay. And then Sienna says, when I look at Google Maps on the mobile app, how does my business post show in the latest in your area?
Ooh, that's a very, I'm trying to picture it in my head. I look at the maps on my mobile app. I do believe it's much almost like that's almost like a social where you're going to see a grid, a feed of the most recent localized posts,
yeah,
and the ability to show through that feed. But that's actually a really, really good question. So I don't want to give a hammered answer because I actually can't say with certainty. But from my understanding on how that feature works, it's almost like a gridded, you know, what are, if you're posting an event, people can see like local events on maps and your post can show recognizing that event, you know, in the area.
But not necessarily something that you can hack to get there.
Yeah, I think that's what they're kind of going at. But I appreciate that question, especially with this transition. And it's something I can definitely get more information for you. If you'd like to connect, Sienna, I believe it's Sienna.
Yeah.
Okay.
Any other questions, anybody? And Eric, do you have your contact information? They can take a screenshot.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I'll go right here. So last page. Again, thank everyone so much for attending. This has been a great event. I want to offer everyone, we always do that complimentary 30-minute discovery call, learn about the business, how we can help out. We are getting a lot of requests right now for the Google listings and profiles. So if you are interested in any, you know, feedback, audit type work or management as well, that's something we're definitely open to talking about, giving feedback on. So thank everyone today. Thank you for the engagement, being involved, Teresa and the BACD, just this opportunity. And I look forward to connecting with you all further.
Thanks so much, Eric. Just one more question. Any insight or tips on legitimate reviews getting caught by the spam filter? Google help was pretty useless.
Yeah, they are. And it's the one constant we've seen in the response from Google as to why is they're claiming advertising or like basically spam, saying the wording that people are using in their reviews, which in their core are advertising when you're giving a testimonial, they appear to be removing them because, again, they use language that's deemed to be like salesy or advertising in nature and trying to promote.
Mm-hmm.
Our understanding, what we can gather from Google and our experience so far as to why that's happening. And it's funny because you're seeing one of those crypto giants right now get absolutely slaughtered. But for a long time during COVID and still, companies are taking advantage of the review portal to advertise their scam service, whatever, right? You leave a Google review on a highly touted page that gets tons of views. You know your review is going to be there and people are going to see it. So you were getting things like, oh, you know, Forex trade or invest in crypto or, you know, trust this Bitcoin specialist. And I think Google's just trying to take a really heavy-handed approach to not let that content translate over because we've seen it rampant on social media. I haven't seen it a lot on the Google profiles, but it might just because they are just basically nixing every other review that a lot of our clients have been getting.
Mm-hmm.
So
good point.
Been frustrating. The support, again, Google help, and even with the Google listing, I actually used to have a direct line. Now they're even forcing us as a partner to submit and wait for a basically you can call us now. But the only thing we can do is really, you know, ask somebody to maybe repost the review at a later date, try to use different terminology. Not everyone's got multiple Google accounts that they can post from. So, you know, can you do it on Facebook? Can you do it somewhere else that will take the review is always a good way to ask it. But that's kind of where we're at right now with that specific kind of issue.
True. Oh, one more question. Cindy says she's on her profile, can't see where to put in search words. Can you help direct me to put in search words?
So when you mean search words, you're in your profile, put in search words. Are we talking about like editing a profile, creating a post?
Cindy, you can unmute yourself so you can ask that question.
Yeah, if you'd love to come off. Just trying to think of exactly what your...
Maybe she means her own search words. There you go.
Yes,
we're guessing.
Yeah, hi. You can hear me?
Yeah,
like I'm a fitness instructor teaching primarily on Zoom. And I this profile was done a while ago. And you can see I haven't done any updates because I didn't realize my app no longer works until I just got on it in your discussion. And I'm like, oh, I don't have an app anymore. So, so yeah, I'm just kind of wanting to put in keywords into it that people would maybe put in when they're trying to search for me so that it would pop up in their search.
Okay.
Like, so, I don't remember. I did this with Durham a while ago. One of the advisors helped me set this up.
Yep. So really what you want to do is, there's not really a place, there is and there isn't. So the services tab, updating your services, is the closest thing to that. One, making sure the primary service of your listing is the most like directly related to what it is you do and what you want to be found for. You know, use fitness instructor as an example. But then in that services column, you can then put things like, we do running clubs and yoga and the 30-minute boot camps and like the very kind of specific services, which is a Google kind of friendly way. You don't want to overdo it, but that is a place where you can just kind of like add worded content that's going to help you trigger on Google, your primary service always being the most relevant. The description. So when you're editing your profile, there's a description space where you can define your business, making sure that's filled out and, you know, using the wording from your website that has your keywords in it that you've, you know, made sure is relevant to your business. Make sure that description's filled out. Another great area, actually, they've just updated as well. If you want to kind of plug in quote unquote keywords or things people might be searching, I'm actually going to go right back to the front. So first, shout out to the sponsors. Thank you all, obviously. But I'm going to go way back for a second here. And something we really want people to take advantage of right now is the Q&A function. So what we recommend business owners do, and it's a great place you can include keywords that will help that ranking, is go to Q&A. You actually just ask a question as your business. It will say you're asking a question as the business, and come up with 3 to 5 frequently asked questions and then provide the answers on Google, and they will show up in your block. It's something we're really promoting now with our clients and utilizing is the Q&A. So edit your services and make sure, you know, your specific service offerings that are generally keyword friendly are there. Make sure your description, your business description, is, you know, thoughtfully done and filled out. And then we would recommend you go to the Q&A section. And if you have a FAQ on your website, take those FAQs and repurpose it, but really fill in that Q&A section as well.
Thank you. That was helpful.
Of course, no problem. Thank you. Great question. I'm glad we got it off mute too, because I knew what you were saying there, but I'm glad I could show this screen too and really pieced it together. Excellent. All right. Any other questions, Google business profile related, or, you know, within arm's reach? Excellent. I think we're exactly at an hour.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you everybody for being here this afternoon. Look forward to seeing you at some of our other events. Thank you, Eric, for your expertise. That was very, very helpful, very useful information. And I think it was time well spent by all of us. So thanks for doing that. And yep. Wishing everybody a good afternoon. Awesome. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Take care.
Thank you, Eric.